So, where are you from, Kevin?
I'm from Rio Piedras, Puerto Rico.
What got you in boxing?
Man, I started boxing when I was 14, 15 years old. I was getting a bunch of trouble when I was young, you know, me and you back in the day. My pops put me in the gym. I fell in love ever since with it, man. Kind of stuck with it, grew into it. And I grew so much love for it, man, that I can't get away from it.
How was your amateur record? Like, how many your career in amateurs?
I got over 80 fights, man. I got a total of 7 losses. 5 of them came at nationals. I won one of those 5 times. I won a state twice. And I won 2009 Ringside World Championship in Kansas City. So I've been around the block, man. Been to nationals, like I said, 5 times. The most I've ever won at nationals was 2 fights, 3 different times. And it was a great experience, man. I never won nationals, but it built me, man. It built me to where I'm at now. I got confidence. I'm a lot smarter. And just got so much love for the sport, man, that I learn something new every day.
Are you trying to do long-term goals, or you got any long-term goals?
Man, it's crazy, man, how I just keep, you know, I stick with it, man. Like I said, man, boxing's my life, man. It changed my life completely around. My kids play a big part in it. My band, you, everybody, man. Everybody plays a big part, a big role in my success in this boxing world, man. If it wasn't for you guys, the support system, my family, my kids, man, I don't know where I would be at today, man. So first of all, I thank the good Lord up above for keeping me steady, keeping me healthy. I thank the Lord for everything, man. I thank for you guys for the support that I get. The love and the community, everything, man. You guys are great, and you guys are pushing right to the next limit.
So let's take it back for your last fight.
My last fight was July 21st in Oshkosh, Wisconsin. I went in this guy's hometown. He was 11-2. It was set for an 8-round fight, main event. I got my eyes split open in the first round from a headbutt. I had a stitches in it, but I stopped the guy in the second round and KO'd him. I stopped him. And again, I thank the good Lord up above for keeping me safe in there and keeping me calm, man, and focused and collected. And I stuck with the game plan and I won, man. And I remember after that fight, I said my next fight was going to be in Vegas. And I fight October 20th, man, in the MGM Park Theater in Las Vegas, October 20th, against an undefeated fighter. He's 9-0 with 9 KOs. He's off Puerto Rican. It's going to be a war, man. It's going to be a war. But I'm ready. I'm training hard. And I'm looking to make a big statement, man. I'm looking to put Iowa on the map.
How's your training camp going so far?
It's going good, man. I'm bouncing back from Omaha to here. I'm working at Cedar Valley Boxing Club. I'm working here at Los Bravos, you know, with my coach, Cedar Bravos. Learning things every day, man. Building muscles that I didn't even know I had, man. I'm getting completely ready for this fight, man. My mindset is set on winning. That's it, just winning. And like I said, man, I'm looking to put Iowa on the map. I know they're overlooking me because I'm just a kid from Iowa, you know. Like I said, man, I believe in the good God up above, and I know this fight's gonna open a lot of doors up for me and my family, my kids, and I'm looking to make a statement, man. I'm looking to go up from here. I'm looking to win a world title, and I'm not looking to stop anytime soon, man. I'm young, I'm in my prime, I feel good, I feel strong. My support system's good. I couldn't ask for a better support system.
And the fight coming up with the guy, the Puerto Rican guy. Any predictions?
It's going to be a war, man. It's going to be a war, but I'm training to win, man. I'm training to win, and I'm winning.
You win.
I'm winning. I can't go and come back with a loss, man. I don't see it happening, man. My hard work, my dedication, my commitment to the sport, it's at a different level right now, man. I feel so confident right now. And I'm not a cocky fighter. I stay off social media, Twitter, all that. I don't like the drama. I let my hands do the talking, and I think October 20th, come Las Vegas, I think everybody's going to recognize me.
Any big names out there you want to fight?
I'm looking to take out anybody in my way, man. Anybody in my way that's in my way to the world title, I'm looking to step up and take a challenge, man. I'm always up for a challenge. If you look at my record, 9-0, man, I haven't fought no bums. No bums at all, man. I'm looking to make a statement, man, and anybody that's in my way can just see me at the weight class, man, because we're here to take names one at a time.
Well, there you have it. Kevin Cruz. Check him out. October 20th in Las Vegas. Any shout-outs to nobody?
Shout-out to you guys, man. Everybody that supports me in the system, man. Everybody that gives me love. Everybody that writes me on Facebook, man. I got a lot of people coming out to Vegas, man. I want to say thank you. You guys mean a lot to me. Very grateful, man. You guys are the best. And again, man, I just want to give the good Lord up above the things he deserves, because without him, none of this would be possible. Without him, I wouldn't be here today, man. So I'm thankful for him. I'm thankful for my family, my kids, my coaches. All you guys, man. You guys mean the world to me. You guys all play a big role in this, and you guys all share a piece of my heart.
All right.
Thank you.
Thank you, Kevin.